In this video, we're going to look at the new Passwords app Apple introduced with iPadOS 18 on the iPad. Now, if you like what you see here or you find it helpful, stick around to the end. I'll tell you a little bit more about myself and how you can help support my efforts in creating these videos. All right, let's take a look at the new Passwords app introduced with iPadOS 18. Let's go over to my iPad. Now, if we look at my iPad, you're going to see that I have an all-new app called Passwords. It's also available on the iPhone with iOS 18 and on the Mac with macOS Sequoia. Basically, what Apple did is they moved the Passwords out of the Settings app here. This is where you found it prior to iPadOS 18. There was a setting called Passwords, and you could find your app passwords as well as website passwords in there. Also, you could look up your Wi-Fi network by going over to the Wi-Fi settings, and you could see your passwords for your Wi-Fi networks. So it's kind of a little bit messy in here, a couple different spots. Well, basically what Apple did is they pulled it all out of the settings and they moved it into this new app. So let's go ahead and open up this app and take a look at how this all works. So I'm going to tap on it to open it up. It does use Face ID or biometric screening to open it up. My iPad here has Face ID, so it recognized my face, and now I can open it up. So if someone were to have your iPad, they would not be able to open up the app. It just doesn't open up. It does use biometric screening for opening up. All right, so this is the new Passwords app. Now, if we look here, you're going to see that it's divided into three different panes on the iPad. We have our first one here, which is where we have all of our different categories. And when I tap on a category, what it'll do is it'll show me all of those passwords in this middle pane here. And then when I tap on any one of those passwords there, what it'll do is it'll show me the details in here. So it's a pretty simple app on how it all works. Let's first take a look at these categories here. It's basically divided into six categories. I could almost say seven when we talk about shared groups. More on that in a little bit. But basically what I'm able to do is view all of my passwords for everything. Or if I wanted to pin down a specific category, such as passkeys or authenticator codes, I could do that as well. So I just tap on it. Let's go ahead and tap on passkeys. I do have a passkey here for Best Buy. So when I tap on it, I can see that Best Buy passkey. So what is a passkey? Well, this is a newer technology. It was introduced, I want to say, maybe a couple years ago. It's not fully embraced yet. It's still a little bit complicated, but the idea is it will replace passwords altogether. Instead of the password being stored in this Passwords app, what it'll do is it'll download a passkey to your device, and when you go to that site, it'll just upload that passkey. So you don't have to remember any type of passwords. Still a little clunky. You're starting to see more sites use it, but I think we're a couple years off before it's really fully implemented. But if you did want to open up the passkey, what you can do is you can tap on it. So I'm going to tap on Best Buy here, and now I can see all the details for that passkey. When we do look at the details, I can also see if there's any security issues when I open up that password. So if there's a breach or anything like that, it would show me what it is there. Let's take a look at codes. Now, if you're familiar with Google Authenticator, this basically replaces Google Authenticator. So if you go to a website, you may be familiar with this. Stripe uses it. If you go to that website, it's going to ask for a 6-digit code, and that code will expire after about a minute. And what you have to do is you have to look up that code. Well, this is where you would go and look up that code. So you no longer have to use Google Authenticator. You can use a Passwords app for authentication. In addition to that, we also have our Wi-Fi passwords here, so I can look up my passwords for any Wi-Fi networks that I've been connected to. Let's go ahead and tap on that. And you can see all my passwords here, or all of my networks. And let's just go ahead and tap on my home network here. And then you're going to see the network name as well as the password. Now, the nice thing is I'm screen sharing this so I can record this. You cannot see that password, but on my iPad, I see a number of dots, and if I were to tap on those dots in this area right down here, I would be able to see or copy that password, but you can't see it. So they're protecting my privacy here when I create this little video. But basically, what you're going to be able to do is see that password there. If you want to forget the network, maybe you no longer use it, you can go ahead and forget that network as well. And then over here, we have security. This is an audit. So I'm able to see when I tap on it, all of the questionable websites or passwords that I use for a website, and then it tells me what is wrong with them. So in these cases here, it's a compromised password. So the idea is what you want to do is you want to go in here and change the password. And the way that you can do that is you can just tap on it. So I'm going to tap on WP Engine. I don't use that anymore, but when I tap on that, what I am able to do is change that password easily enough. Just tap on that and it'll go and log in, and then I can go and change the password. So they kind of help you go and change or clear your audits over here. In addition to that, we also have our deleted password. So when you go and delete a password, I can go and look that back up. Down towards the bottom here, we also have shared groups. So what are shared groups? Well, what I can do is I can create a new group here, and then I can share with my wife, for example. So let's say I wanted her to get into my banking. What I can do when I tap on a password is go and share with that group. So I would create a group here, and then I would go and add my banking over to that group. And then Beth, in her passwords app on her iPhone, her iPad, her Mac, she'd be able to view that password. And if we changed it, I changed it, or she changed it, it would change for both of us. To move a password to a group, all you have to do is just go and tap on it. So let's go back over to my passwords here. I'm just going to go to the first one. I am a member of ARP. And if I wanted to change my grouping, I could do that. So if I wanted to share this with Johnny, you see, can see I have a group here for Johnny. What I would be able to do is tap on this, and I can share it with Johnny here. I can also just go and create a new group. So you can have multiple groups in there as well. If you want to go and add your own username and password, add it manually, you can do that too just by tapping on the plus here. So I tap on the plus, and then from here, what I'm able to do is go and add a name, the username, go and put a password in there and share it with a group. And of course, I can always go and add notes as well. And these notes are searchable in the search field here. So if you want to put a note in there what it's for, you can do that as well. We can sort it. You're going to see I have sort down here. Tap on this. And then from here, I can sort it by descending or ascending order, the date that it was edited, created, or even show the website or title name. Now, right now, it is showing it by title here. But if I wanted to show it by website instead of title, you can tap on website here, and then you can show it by website instead of title. To edit a password, all you have to do is just tap on edit here. And when I do, I can go and edit that password. But basically, what I'm able to do is just go out and fill these different fields out. And when I am done, I just tap on done, and it'll save any changes. So we can see it's a pretty robust passwords app. We can also select our passwords and then delete multiple passwords. So if I go and tap on this, from here, I'm able to select my passwords. I can select all of them if I wanted to. I don't really want to do that. And then once I do that, let's go ahead and select one. Once I do that, what I'm able to do is delete that. So we can select multiple passwords as well and then delete them. I'm going to tap on done. We're not going to delete that. So that's the passwords app. Now let's take a look at the settings. We do have a few different options within our settings for this. So what we need to do is we do need to go to our settings app. So I'm going to swipe up and then we go over to our settings app. And then from here, what we need to do is go all the way down to the bottom. Apple changed the settings app a little bit. Basically, your app settings, including Apple apps, are located down here at the bottom. So I tap on apps. And then what I do is I go over to passwords. This is in alphabetical order. So I'm just going to tap on the P over here. And when I do, you're going to see that I have passwords here. So I tap on passwords. And here are my settings for it. So what settings do we have here? Well, the first one is I can show my accounts as. This is the same thing that I showed you within the passwords app. I can show it as titles, or I can show it as websites. I'm going to leave it as titles. In addition to that, we can detect our compromised passwords. So if you don't want to see that audit, you can turn that off just by going over to the right here. I can also have it suggest strong passwords. I would recommend leaving this on. We want to have a strong password in there so it's not easily guessable. And then I can also automatically upgrade any passkeys. Again, I would recommend leaving this on. Down towards the bottom, We can also open up the Passwords app directly from the Settings app if you wanted to open it up. And down at the very bottom, we have our autofill settings. So this is going to take you to a different spot within the Settings app. And again, I am in my password settings. So when I go over to autofill here, what it's going to do is open up my autofill settings within the Settings app. So I am no longer in my password settings. I'm in the autofill settings. So what options do we have here? Well, basically what I can do is I can tell it to autofill. I would recommend leaving this on. We want to use a Passwords app. So I just go and turn that on. In addition to that, where do we want it to autofill from? Well, from the Passwords app, of course. You could also use 1Password if you have another third-party Passwords app. You can tell it to autofill from that as well. And in addition to that, you can have it autofill from a browser. So I'm going to turn on Google Chrome here, and now it'll autofill from that browser. With verification codes, those are those two-factor authentication codes that we get via text message. Do you want it to delete it after it's used? When you turn this on, what it'll do is it'll automatically delete it once it is used to enter a site. And then we can set how we want to set up our codes. This is that authenticator, such as Google Authenticator. I am using Passwords now. I'm no longer using Google Authenticator, so I just have it set for the Passwords app. So that's the new Passwords app on the iPad with iPadOS 18. In addition to that, they also introduced this on the iPhone with iOS 18 and the Mac with macOS Sequoia. And it syncs using iCloud. So any changes that you make within the Passwords app on your iPad will show up on your iPhone and your Mac. When you open up the Passwords app, it does use the biometric screening to make sure that anyone can't just open it up. And then once you do open it up, you can see all of your different categories for your passwords. It also does an audit. So it's a pretty good app, especially for version 1. I'm very pleased with it. Now, how does it compare to something like 1Password? Well, 1Password does do more. So if you need to keep track of your passport or your credit cards and things like that, then you want to stick with 1Password. It's also cross-platform, where the Passwords app is, you know, primarily used for the Mac, although I think you can get it on the Windows with an extension, the iCloud extension. But basically, if you do use a password manager for more than just tracking your passwords, what you may want to do is stick with your current password manager, such as 1Password. But if you just need a basic password manager, that's all I need is just a basic password manager, I'm very happy with this new Passwords app. Again, like I said, especially for a version 1. So that is the new Passwords app on the iPad with iPadOS 18. Now, if you found this video helpful, what you may want to do is like the video. You can share it with your friends and family, or even subscribe to my channel. In addition to that, you may want to check out my site, danstutorials.com. Although I have over 400 videos on YouTube, I have a lot more on my site, danstutorials.com. I've been doing this a lot longer on my site than I have on YouTube. So how can you help support my efforts in creating these videos? Well, my site, danstutorials.com, is a membership-based site. You can get to all of the videos, but they do include ads. When you become a member of my site, I take out all of the ads. You have access to an AI assistant modeled after an Apple genius, and you have access to my classes and webinars, which I hold on a regular basis. In addition to that, you're also helping support a small business. It is just me in a corner office of my house. I turned a spare bedroom into a studio. I'm not part of some large organization. So when you become a member, you are directly supporting my efforts in creating these videos. Check out danstutorials.com for more information, and thanks for watching.